Hopefully, it will be not so boring for you just after lunch. I'm here to show you how easy it is to create a new embedded application using the Eclipse RCP-based application that will work. There will be two short demos on different concepts that I will present. So, okay, first presentation of ST Microelectronics. It is a semiconductor company who sells silicon and microcontrollers. ST Microelectronics provides a wide range of of microcontrollers, specifically for the automotive applications. And I will focus my talk about the SPC5 family, which is a power PC-based architecture microcontrollers. Inside the SPC5 ecosystems, the SPC5 Studio tool is the development tool that we are using and providing to our customers who bought the microcontrollers in order to use them. There is a short focus on some of the SPC5 family. You can see that there are plenty of them, and in particular, they come with their own capabilities and peripherals, so that you can choose for the application that you want to design what kind of microcontroller you want. STMicroelectronics have a minimum longevity commitment of 15 years for all these components, so that our automotive vendors can use them for a long term. I will talk about the persons who are responsible for this development. Basically, there are two teams. One team dedicated to the IDE itself. This team is located in Le Mans and responsible for the architecture point of view, down to the test, the continuous integration as well. We are four people. And the application software team is the team based in Italy. There are two sites in Italy where the drivers and reference and demos comes. They also take the part of the customer support for the MCUs. I am the software architect of this SPC5 Studio framework, working in Le Mans. STMicroelectronics does not provide only microcontrollers for the automotive industry. There is a specific division inside ST that provides microcontrollers for other purposes, and in particular, the STM32 ARM Cortex-M based microcontrollers. There are two different Eclipse-based environments used inside the STM32 ecosystems. The first one is the system workbench for STM32. It manages to create some application, by the way, the same kind of concept that I provided in a specific studio. And the second tool is a tool coming from a recently acquired company that joined STMicroelectronics in late last year, more dedicated to the advanced decoding, advanced profiling, and advanced debugging features of the ARM microcontrollers. These two tools are going to be merged into only one in a future, in a short future. What is SPC5 Studio? The first requirements we have got from it was 6 years ago was to have a mass market tool, free of charge mass market tool, for providing an environment for our customer which is easy to use and without any fee. The installation should be easy for the user to create a new application from scratch and then to have a few minutes later a code running on its microcontroller. For this, we organize this as components, and contributors to the project should be able to to contribute to the project easily without any Java knowledge or something like this. And then we wanted to have a common way of delivering software and updates to our customers. So we went to Eclipse IDE environment based on the applications. Basically, our applications are plugins, components that each component is configurable. It comes with a generic code part and a configurable part. The purpose of the SPCWeb Studio tool is mainly to assemble those different components, configure them, and then generate the code relative to this. For creating an application, we have two different wizards, one for creating an application from scratch, the other one to reuse the hundreds of demo applications that we have on the database. How do we manage the application configuration? First, we use an extension point inside the RCP framework so that the developers of a component should be able to create an extension based on the extension point defined by the tool. A component is mainly based on a group of properties, each property having a certain number of attributes. Let's say maybe the min and max value for a name for an integer value would be used for testing if the property is valid or not. So we are using this, the product development environment, the extension editor for it. This results in, from the component structure that we see, the tool is reading it and integrating it just to provide the GUI to enter values inside the tool. So that from the component structure, we define the GUI generated on the fly for the configuration. But the configuration is based on a certain number of components. The database of components is present as all the accessible extensions that extends the extension point provided by the SPCWeb Studio, where each component comes with its structure. As I said, the structure is the group of properties. And then some pre-marker templates to generate the code using the configuration of the properties. From this configuration, we assemble some components between them just to create the structure of the application. For example, here we have the platform component, which is the main component of the application. This is the one on which we will upload the code. This is the one representing the MCU. Yeah. And then there is a software layer architecture of the different components that we want to organize our application. The configuration, after all, is stored inside the XML file, inside the tool, which is used to generate the code from the different components in this application. So the generic code and the template from the different components inside the application are configured using the different values of the properties inside the tool. And then the files are generated inside the C project. So there are additional files that have been created inside this file. And as soon as we have this application, we are able to generate, to compile it and to download it into the platform. Maybe it will be clearer with the demonstration. So here is how it looks like. It is no surprise, you know, RCP CDT-based architecture. So I want to create a file, an application from scratch. So I create it. I have to add to it the main platform. In that case, I will take this one amongst the, all the list of the available platforms. On this platform, I will add compatible components. There are only one of it. There are many other incompatible components who are not compatible with this kind of platform. So I choose the only one possible there. And then the configuration is like this. You choose a component inside the application tree. Then you go inside the outline to choose what is the group of properties that you want to modify. And then from there you can modify the value. For example, here I want to choose I have three different compilers. I can choose one of them, and then save the application. As soon as I did this, for example, this board initialization component is the one responsible for the I/O signals inside the MCU. This is done using the I/O signal definition is provided inside the reference manual, which is there. This one is the reference manual for this specific MCU. And I have to dig inside this huge reference manual the way to configure it. So I extracted just a part of it with what is necessary for you to understand, hopefully. If I want to put one LED, for example, connected to a pin on my microcontroller, I have to check where I would like to connect it. So I decided to connect it to this one of these two pins. It is then elsewhere in the documentation there is the table, a textual table that describes how it is defined. It is defined here, this PC port C2 functions is available on this kind of register. So I have to go to the register there to see how I have to configure it. So I have to make it manually, unfortunately. I will show you later on another demonstration of how we modified it at the end. So if I want to use this port to name it like this, and I choose one setting saying that I want to go output on this setting. So back to this list of I/O this signal description. I have this list that has been set, and now I am able to generate the code associated to this. So there are many files that have been generated from this application. For example, this board edge file contains from the different templates that there is, for example, the definition of the LED that I have just created. And then this board initialization component comes with its library containing the driver which is able to check this particular part of the microcontroller. Okay, so after this generation, I'm able to make the code, to compile the code using the compiler that I've chosen. Okay, so this was the first configuration that was available with the tool. Let's go back to the presentation. We will go to the advanced configuration now. The reference manual that I've shown you shortly contains the exhaustive list of registers and tables and signals and many cross-references inside this document, but it is not useful. It is very difficult to use, as I mentioned. It is very confusing for the user. That's why we decided to go for a more graphical part of the configuration. First, we will present the way the pin mapping have been reused inside the tool, and then there are two different other more difficult and graphical things inside the inside the reference document, which are very most difficult to use than the first. So I cut them in two different graphical editors. The first one is the okay. We took the data from the reference manual. We have to find a way to get it, to get the data from the MCU designers, the way they like the I/O signals, for example, to be represented inside the MCU. So they attach this document to the reference manual. And then from then, we get this information, we extract it with an XML export from this Excel file. We made a transformation with some XSL transformation scripts in order to cope this file with the model which we are using inside the tool for the representation, for the configuration, the graphical configuration. This is done again using extensions massively. Each pin map fragments, each platform component comes with these pin map fragments containing an extension which defines what is the file which has been converted in the previous step. And then we provide it to the fragment. And then the tool is gathering all these fragments to constitute the database of the different pin map extensions. The second part of the graphical configuration was the two other configuration parts. Are the main idea behind this was to use the exact picture from the reference manual. We export the picture from the reference manual in an SVG file. Then we organize the configuration of the tool inside a SWT browser into which we display the SVG picture. And we add some JavaScript code in order to animate the picture using the SVG objects inside the picture. And we make the link between the model object behind to be modified by the tool. Here is the result. So to the left, you have the description of the MCU block diagram inside the reference manual. This is translated here inside the SWT browser inside the tool. So each blue component here is a component with which you are able to interact with. The same kind of editor has been done for the clock tree. The clock tree basically inside the MCU, the way to modify the different frequencies for the different peripherals to use. So again, it is exactly the same. Again, some SVG fragments containing the definitions of the binding between the model object and the graphical object. Okay. As soon as the user enters a value inside the model, we are able to check that everything is correct, and as soon as there is an error, the error is displayed using the decorator as well, not surprisingly. Maybe a short demo of how it looks like. So maybe I will show you in the same way the way we use the different. We have here the choice between all the different platforms available. Let's take the same one. Here you have the filter of what are the drivers you want to test. If I want to test the serial driver, I have only this limited list of demonstration applications. And then I import them into my project, my environment. So here it is. If I go to the board initialization component that we modified earlier, you can see that in that case we have four pins that have already been defined. And then when we click there, you can see the picture of the Okay, so the same one that I used to have before, this one, I am able to modify directly if I go back here inside the reference manuals for this PC2 function there. There are many functions that are available there. This one's in input-output, this one only in input. So this is exactly what is done there. And choose here if I want an input, it is only the one that I done there. In our case, it is a general purpose input. And then from the settings that you have there, you're able to see that different bits of the registers are managed using the tool directly, so that you can modify it easier. The same has been done as well for the MCU block diagram. So from this part, we're able to go, for example, here for the LinkFlex driver, I'm able to go directly from there to the configuration part, which is modifying this this part of the application. Okay, and then the same for the plot tree. Plot tree portion of the code is the same as well. So let's have this split in two sides. Maybe I can show it a little larger. Okay. If I want to modify this part of the component, I can effect again. Okay, I can modify the different parts in the same way it is transparently done by using the model behind it. Okay, maybe I'm late. I will go to the next slides. Okay, the typical usage of SPC5 Studio is first to explore what is possible to use with the different pin maps and so on. So the user uses the tool to navigate from one model to the other one, just to see how it can arrange the different pin signals according to the board it's targeting. And then from there, you do not need to generate any code. For the prototyping version, you can move to the smoothly to the prototype. You do not need to add anything apart from the compilers. We have a partnership with a high-tech company who provides 1 year for each SPC5 Studio, 1 year of a compiler, free compiler for SPC5 users. And then the PLS starter kit version, PLS is providing a limited edition of their debugger that we use to generate the code and to debug and to push the code inside the platform and test that it is working fine. And then when you want to industrialize the project, you can add whatever libraries and user code that they want. You can patch the code if they want, and then they have to move to the full commercial support of the PLS and the high-tech compiler. So probably, okay, 5 minutes now. Here is the list of the different components and different Eclipse projects that we are using inside the SPC5 Studio. So first, it is based on Eclipse CDT, not surprisingly, and then we are using massively the platform development environment using the extensions and the Eclipse RCP, of course. So we added a lot of things. The SWT browser, as I mentioned before, the common navigation framework, the welcome pages, all our help pages are basically managed inside the same tools. We are using the target platform definition from Michael Barbero as well, the modeling framework in some part of the code, and a lot of other plugins. And even for the development of the tool itself, of course, we are using the Eclipse Git integration the typo Babel plugins, the Maven typo plugins. I don't know. It is the typo plugin of Maven. And then the other tools, in particular the RCP testing tool to test the UI. And for the deployment part, we are using the update site, of course, and then we provide on our site, myst.com, the specific studio executable to be installed. Then the updates are done through the update site or using the Eclipse marketplace. And then we have a special part for dedicated secured update site for the feature that we only aim to be delivered at some customers, which I'm not authorized to show here. And then for the testing part, we have the UI testing part uses the SquashTM tool in order to gather our requirements, to create our test campaigns, and to execute them using SquashTA and Jenkins. And again, this test, this job inside Jenkins uses the RCP testing tool in order to automate it. And for testing the embedded part of the code, we are able using this kind of box. It is an in-house box. We designed this box just to be able to plug it into Jenkins job in order to be able to test one platform or the other one. From this box, we are able to switch on, switch off the different platforms, and then provide the code and upload the code inside the microcontroller, and then get the result of the test, and then inject it back into the SquashTN results. This is what I would like to say about SPCL Studio. If you have questions, I will be glad to answer. No questions?
You said you tool is used during prototyping. Could you
prototyping? Sorry.
No, one slide. There are three types of usage.
Yes.
Of,
let's go back to it. This one?
So it's the tool is free for every stage? Or
the tool is free for every stage, yes, all right. This one, the Explorer mode, uses only a limited set of drivers. The one that I've shown inside your application, you're able to gather, to assemble the different components. There are some components containing only just very limited things, just for you to get access to the board pin map definitions, for example. And then from this, you are able to play with the tool without compiling anything, without generating any code. And then you can play with it and then export the pin mapping that you've got after your analysis and provide it to the team who is responsible to generate the PCB, the printed circuit board, and then go in production with this. So, and then from this part, after that, you can take the same application and then replace the different drivers that you have and try it directly with using a pre-compiler or and you can start to work with it. Is it clearer? Yes?
You say usually that your tool on this port is based on microcontroller or not.
Yes.
And if you do plan to support any of the kind of microcontrollers, like the STM32.
Okay, so I presented the currently the tool who is inside the STM32 is my ecosystem is the system workbench for STM32. But I think with a little effort, it could be possible to have this. Currently, we support the SPC5 family inside the tool, but yes, it has been tested already. We are able to make it, but currently it is done by the SIM, the system workbench for SIM32, which is much more dedicated for this, which is provided for free as well. Maybe it seems I've been faster than expected, so if you have 3 minutes, 3 minutes more. So if you have a few questions left? Nobody? Okay, thank you then. Thank you.